In the last decade, belt drivetrains have increased in popularity on urban bikes, and this is for many reasons. Belts are clean, silent, and can last 3 to 4 times longer than chains. They also do not rust and do not require any grease or lubrication either. This keeps bike maintenance to a minimum and ensures you'll never get black marks on your hands or pants again. But belt drive systems have always relied on the use of a gearbox or internal gear hub to provide multiple gear ratios. Until now, the prototype multi-speed belt sprocket that we're discussing today could be an internal gear hub killer, replacing the 2 and 3 speed models sold on millions of bikes each year. Veer Shift Drive aims to combine the efficiency and performance of derailleur gear systems with the durability and low maintenance of belt drives. In this video, I'll first explain how external belt shifting works. I'll then compare Veer Shift Drive with internal gear hubs, we'll take a look at the most suitable bikes for this drivetrain, and we'll finish up with some frequently asked questions. So, how does this crazy transforming sprocket work? Veer Shift Drive places 6 rotating segments onto a typical freewheel at the rear hub. On each side of the segments is a different number of belt teeth. When the rider initiates a shift, the segments flip one by one, allowing the belt to transition to the opposite side. By the time all 6 segments have rotated 180 degrees, the diameter of the sprocket will have changed, increasing or decreasing the gear ratio of the bike. The segment rotations are driven by pedal force, which allows the segments to flip at a rate that perfectly matches the rider's cadence. You'll also notice the rotations are all completed in the zone that's never in contact with the belt. This guarantees the sprocket is always locked in one gear or the other. A tensioner takes up the belt slack and ensures the belt stays on, even over rough terrain. Upon product launch, the up and down shifts will be made using a wireless shifter at the handlebar, but a cable-operated shifter will be available down the line. As far as I'm aware, this futuristic drivetrain is the first 2-speed belt sprocket for bicycles. Instead of the belt shifting across the rear sprockets, as we see on chain drive, this sprocket shifts underneath the belt. This is an important feature, as belts must operate in a perfectly straight line. The high gear is 1.4 times larger than the low gear, which might not sound like a lot, but it can be all a bicycle needs in a flatter urban setting, especially if it's fitted to an electric bike. For reference, competing internal gear hubs have a range of 138 to 186%. Shift drive will drop in place of a cassette on existing wheels. In fact, this drivetrain should be retrofittable to almost any bike, as the tensioner provides the appropriate belt tension, and the Veer belts can be uniquely split and installed on any bicycle frame, including folding bikes and even full suspension mountain bikes. So, what are the main advantages of external belt shifting? To start, it's a full kilogram lighter, and can operate with a higher drive efficiency. This is because it engages fewer components than a gear hub. After all, planetary gear sets wear away inside hubs and generate friction. With external belt shifting, you can shift under full power, and there won't be a big clunk between gear changes. This is because the belt slowly transitions across the morphing sprockets, allowing for super smooth gear changes. Unlike internal gear hubs, shift drive is compatible with rear hub motors found on the majority of e-bikes around the world. This is a big deal, as bikes with the rear hub motors are currently limited to either derailleur gears or expensive gearboxes. External belt shifting is compatible with mid-drive motors too, and it's perhaps even more suitable than a gear hub, as it can potentially handle more input torque. And in the event of component failure, replacing a belt sprocket will be much easier than cutting an internal gear hub from a wheel and rebuilding it onto a new rim. The advantages of shift drive all sound pretty good, but it's important to note that internal gear hubs have been refined on bicycles for over a century, so they will be a tough component to beat. Let's now understand why internal gear hubs are so great. Gear hubs have proven the test of time. They are affordable and reliable thanks to their enclosed design that protects the gears from the elements, extending the hub lifespan and ensuring consistent performance. Gear hubs require very little maintenance, and you can shift gears on them anytime, including while stationary. In addition, the shifting of most internal gear hubs is made using a reliable cable-activated mechanism. No batteries, electronic components, or wireless signals are required to make shifts, keeping things as simple as possible. So, what will it take for shift drive to beat internal gear hubs? But first, if you're interested in belt drivetrains, you might like my Touring and Bikepacking Bike Buyer's Guides. These guides will teach you everything you need to know about the bikes before allowing you to compare hundreds of bikes at the back of the books. There are dozens of belt drive models, and the best bit is that the books are updated yearly for free, so you'll always have the latest copy. As shift drive is still in development, it will take a while before we know whether it's high performing, reliable, and long lasting. If Veer wants to go head to head with multi-speed hubs, here are some things they will need to perfect. The multi-speed belt sprockets need to last as long as regular belt sprockets. The rotating segments need to be packed with grease and well sealed so that they can freely rotate even with exposure to dust and debris. The belt needs to stay on the sprocket under high torque applications, as well as over rough terrain. The wireless shifter needs to be fast and accurate with a user-friendly design. And the tensioner needs to be durable and silent in operation. If any of these things are not up to scratch, bike manufacturers will simply stick to tried and tested internal gear hubs. Let's now take a look at the types of bikes that will best suit shift drive. Number 1. Budget urban bikes. Low-cost urban bikes are designed to be as low maintenance and reliable as possible, so it makes sense to pair them with multi-speed belt drives. Bikes in this category include commuting bikes, folding bikes, rental bikes, and beach cruisers. The Priority Cycles bike range will give you a good idea of what these bikes look like and how they are priced. Number 2. Mid-drive e-bikes. Mid-drive urban e-bikes are another bike category that's suitable for shift drive. Mid-motors can take advantage of the lower gear ratio to provide more wheel torque up steep hills, allowing the motor to operate more efficiently and increasing the overall range. Alternatively, bike manufacturers could leverage the lower gearing of shift drive to instead fit smaller, lighter, and less powerful motors to their e-bikes, which would allow for smaller batteries too. Number 3. Hub drive e-bikes. Shift drive would also be suitable for hub drive e-bikes from brands like Rose, Geos, and Momentum. While the motor will not take advantage of the lower gearing on steep climbs, the rider will be more effective at helping the motor, which ultimately increases e-bike range. Number 4. Light electric vehicles. Veer has made it quite clear that they want their products on more than just bicycles. Shift drive could also end up on lightweight scooters, mopeds, and all kinds of urban delivery vehicles. Before I sum everything up, let's go over some frequently asked questions to make sure you're fully informed about this unique drivetrain. How much will Veer shift drive cost? If Veer wants this gear system to be competitive with internal gear hubs, the sprocket and tensioner will likely need to cost under $150. How much will Veer shift drive weigh? The front sprocket, two-speed rear sprocket, belt, and tensioner total 570 grams. This means it's about 50% heavier than just a chain, or around a kilogram lighter than an internal gear hub with a belt drivetrain. What would happen if the rotating segments jammed? If any of the rotating segments jam with debris, there is an internal clutch-like mechanism that will prevent the shift from occurring. The worst-case scenario is that you would be locked into one gear should you jam a segment. What would happen if you stopped pedaling mid-shift? The gear change would simply pause temporarily and resume once you've started pedaling again. This is the same as a derailleur. Do the missing belt teeth in between the segments affect performance? There will undoubtedly be more flexing in the belt, but whether this translates to durability concerns or additional drive resistance, we simply don't know yet. Veer shift drive is a novel prototype that certainly shows a lot of promise. Compared to internal gear hubs, shift drive could be lighter, more efficient, easily serviced or replaced, compatible with hub motors, shifted under full power, able to handle more input torque, and easily retrofittable to existing urban bikes. If Veer wants this to be the drivetrain of choice on millions of urban bikes around the world, they will now have to prove that this drivetrain is reliable and long-lasting. Let's wish them the best of luck.